Hello friends, welcome to Alankar Pharmacy classes again. In this video, I am going to tell you about the very important experiment that is performed by Osborne Reynolds to understand the nature of flow of fluid, which becomes the history in the field of fluid mechanics. So stay with me till the end of the video to understand the whole experiment. So without wasting our time, let's start. First of all, the Osborne Reynolds, who is behind this experiment, he was a British engineer, and he demonstrated behavior of flow of fluids through this experiment in 1883. And the Reynolds number that he derived is nowadays a widely used dimensionless parameter in the field of fluid mechanics, as we all know that the Reynolds number is used to understand the nature of flow of fluids, whether it is laminar or turbulent in nature. Interestingly, Reynolds never named his concept as Reynolds number. His concept was named as a Reynolds number in the honor of his name by Arnold Sommerfeld in 1908. So let's understand what he has done. Actually, he explained his concept through simple apparatus. As you can see here, there is a tank which contains a water. This is a tank. This is a tank of water. And there is another tank, a small tank that containing a dye. Here there is another tank which contains a dye. And there is a glass tube. Here you can see this is a glass tube which is transparent enough so that the flow of fluid can be easily seen through it. So initially, what he has done, he kept dye over here and he allows the dye to mix with this water through a very fine bottleneck valve. As you can see, this is the glass tube and the dye is mixing into the glass through a very fine hole which is located almost center here. Through this valve, the dye is actually mixing with the water and the flow of water is like this, and the flow of water is regulated by using this regulating valve. And he has used actually the aniline dye for the experiment. So there are basically three observations. In the first observation, he observed that at the low velocity, the dye filament in the glass tube was forming a straight line. And this is because of simply the low velocity of water. So in this case, what is happening? He observed there is a straight line of dye. There is a straight line of the dye. This is the dye line. And there is a straight line of the dye, which is actually the parallel to the glass pipe. And the colored water maintains its identity through the pipe. He named this kind of flow as laminar or viscous or streamlined flow. In this type of flow, he explained that the layers slides over each other and thus no mixing with the adjacent layers. Here you can see if the two layers of liquid, it runs like this, so there is no mixing of molecules between these layers, and thus the molecules will travel together in a particular direction in a perfect laminar way without intermixing with the adjacent layers. And such kind of flow he termed as the laminar flow. And there is another observation that is after increasing the velocity of the water. So what he found, that increasing the velocity of the water, the color of the thread of dye water disappears and the entire water gets uniformly colored, which is the indication of the complete mixing of solution. Here what is happening, when he increased the flow of water, the molecules which are traveling in the adjacent layers, because of the increase of the velocity of water, there is a formation of the eddies and vortices, and that's why the arrangement of molecules become disturbed and that's why there is an intermixing of the molecules between the layers. And here you can see the whole water is now becomes colored because of the presence of dye. And this is the because of the flow of water in this case is become turbulent simply. There is another observation, and in this case he defined a term which is known as critical velocity, and it is defined as the average velocity of any fluid at which the viscous flow changes into turbulent flow, and the mixing of layers occurs due to the formation of eddies. Here you can see initially when velocity of the liquid is less, there is a laminar flow, and when we increase the velocity, there is a formation of eddies, and finally there is an intermixing of the layers, and the whole water mixed with the dye solution, and in this way the whole water is now colored with the color of the dye. And that's why there should be certainly a transition phase between the flow of fluid changes from laminar to turbulent, and he named this velocity of water as the critical velocity. And after this experiment, he found that there are the four different factors which influence the flow conditions of fluid. The first factor is the diameter of pipe, another factor is the average velocity, third factor is the density of liquid, and the fourth one is the viscosity of fluid. And out of which he derived an equation which is nowadays known as Reynolds number, that is equals to the d diameter of the pipe, mu is the average velocity of the liquid, rho is the density of liquid, and finally this eta is the viscosity of fluid. As we know that if the Reynolds number is less than 2100, the flow will be laminar. If it is greater than 4000, then it is turbulent. And if it is between 2100 to 4000, it is in the critical region, or we also called it as transitional phase. So if you want to understand about the Reynolds number in a more detailed manner, you can refer my this video. And there is another video related to flow of fluid, that is the fluid statics and fluid dynamics. And lastly, there is another video, that is what is fluid and types of fluid. You can refer my these videos, and the links are provided in the description box.
Subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get the latest video and updates.